of it.
All right, good evening. Welcome to Hong Kong U Library, and welcome back to those of you who've been here before. It's a very special book night, another special book night this evening. The title of the book itself is really quite intriguing, Philosophy of Fearism. More than just a book talk, it's actually an author talk, because we have the author here tonight to talk about his experience in writing the book and what the book is about. If you think about it, the concept is really quite simple. The philosophy of fearism, what we fear, we strive to eliminate. And so much of our consciousness is driven by eliminating fear. So the concept itself makes a lot of sense, but the execution has great complexity. So I'd like to introduce and welcome Mr. Desh Subba. So he will be the speaker this evening. But before we go any further, I'll also introduce the moderator, who is Ray Devraj. Now, Ray is a primary school teacher, and he's also a public relations officer in a school in Yuen Long. He also has his own radio station, which is called HK Nepali Radio, and he has a program on RTHK as well. He also considers himself to be a educational activist. So with that, I'm going to ask Ray to do a proper introduction of Desh and get the ball rolling. Okay, thanks.
Let's welcome Desh Subba. Maybe have a seat first. Is that okay? So good evening, everybody. My name is Ray Devraj, and I want to have a seat with a relaxed mode. So we're going to start further ahead. Well, Mr. Desh Subba is a philosopher, novelist, poet. He was born in Nepal. It is called Dharan, the eastern part of Nepal, and currently living with his family in Hong Kong since last two decades. Beside this philosophy of fearism, he has written four novels, and he's a well-known writer in Nepali language, in Nepal and India. It's my pleasure to be the moderator today and dare to do today. Thank you for coming, everybody. About the Desh Subba, he's the, he's advocating about the philosophy of fearism. He wants to say that fear carries us forward, not backward, backwards. Fear is the source of all invention. He has actually, South China Morning Post yesterday also mentioned about this one. Today, English is our second language. Also, this second language. My first language, our first language is Nepali. So let me go on further ahead, and I have a small introduction and some overview part of this in a slide. So today, we come here to see you all. Okay, this is a novel. I already mentioned all about this one. So, fearism is a gift to the world from Nepal. It's a part of overview. Professor Dr. Tonka Prasad Neupane, chairman of Fearism Study Center, by Charik Chintan, 2066 FIES, means this is the Nepalese debt, actually. Fearism of Desh Subba has second the foundation of Nepali literature and intellectual wall. It has mentioned in Indian Literary Academy winner, Arunachal Pradesh, India. Yeah. So fearism is under the new criticism. Yeah, it has mentioned. Professor Dr. Kavita Lama, head of the Department of Sikkim University, Sikkim, India. Yeah. Fearism is, Kavita Lama. After this, Desh Subba and I have put forth the foundation for philosophy and theory of fearism, to which Subba has done the most systematic work. Dr. Michael Fisher, these are the others come in. Fearism is a new perspective to look at life and the world. Professor Dr. Sanjeev Upreti, Central Department of English, Trivandrum University. To claim this text as the world, dictionary of fearism cannot be an exaggeration, in my opinion. Dr. Durga Prasad Arial. Yeah. So this is the blue ink review. So please welcome Desh Subba. He's here today. So please put your hands together for him to welcome, to listen him. So Mr. Subba, just go on. Okay. So what do you want to say?
Thank you, Mr. Devaraj Rai. Thank you, Mr. Peter and Mr. Giri. And thank you, Hong Kong University, because Hong Kong University has given me good chance to speak about my new book, Philosophy of Fearism. This fear word is not invented by myself. This word is starting from very long time, from the primitive times, historical, starting from the civilizations. But what I am doing is what the other people, other writers, philosophers, doing about this one. Before me, I think when I was working in this philosophy, I tried to find how the people were working in the past before me. I tried to find, I studied some books, but most of the writers, philosophers, they used this word as a negative. Mostly when we read every books, every subjects, this fear word is coming. But when we just see the meaning of this word, mostly they were just using as a negative. But what is the new view I have just given here? I just want to make it positive first, because fear is one of the positive consciousness and very beautiful consciousness as well. If we go back to the human civilization, and civilization starting from the fear, this is my logic. I don't know if we are agree with this or not, but this is a new prospect. So new prospect is very difficult to believe at first. When we are hearing new terms, it looks like very strange. But when we go back to our civilization, and civilization is starting, I said, from the fear. And during that time, we had the fear of eating and sitting and some enemies. And they just invent the stone weapons. All the civilizations base is starting from the stone weapons. And weapons is for just protect themselves from the enemies, from the animals. And most thing is they want to kill some animals and they want to eat. If they did not have this kind of weapon that time, it was very difficult for them to survive. And survival is the very strong thing from the ancient time to the now. What we are doing today is also for the just surviving. Exactly, I'm feeling a little bit inferiority complex myself, and inferiority and introversion, and just like some kind of confusion and fear. Exactly not I'm feeling this one. This is the human temperament, and most of the people, all we used to feel. Mostly when we are in the students' time, students, I think the participation of students is also many here. So I just want to give some examples and utilizations and how to we have to just treat with our fear. According to the words, like I just mentioned before, like introversion, inferiority complex, like this kind of so many, like feel shy. Because of this, we cannot show our expertise, our talency. And when we cannot show our talency, and we cannot achieve the success in our life. But the terms when we are going to study about the words, these words are different exactly. But like I said, inferiority complex, how the inferiority complex is built up. What is the meaning? Means always we are feeling, we are cannot do, I cannot do this work, I cannot write, I cannot speak, and somebody is very smart in writing, suppose, and he cannot speak in front of like a stage here. Because this is also one kind of inferiority complex, and this inferiority complex is just behind the inferiority complex, there is a fear. This is my logic.
Okay, Mr. Subba, actually, I just want to interrupt you. Is it fear, purism can be a philosophy?
Oh, yes. I want to ask this question to the dear audience. Because this question is asked me many times in my interviews. Before I said, the fear is a normal word, and it cannot be philosophy. And they always ask me these questions in the mostly in the interview time. And I asked the audience, dear audience, please, can you just tell me, anybody, fear can be philosophy or not? Any students, please? Because this is a controversy in our mind, can be or cannot be? I said can, but how? This is the question, how? But your mind is also maybe dividing, it can or not. But I said, before I go to my this the question, I want to ask the, all the audience that one of the prominent or the famous philosophy of the world is the Marxism. We know that is. But I want to ask this hall and everybody, how many people of this hall is touched with the Marxism, the philosophy? Personally, practical in daily life? Anybody? Anybody do you have? Marxism, because this is the one of the biggest and prominent philosophy in the world. But I think in practically, in the daily life, it is barely used. And just one of the major sentences of the Marxism is class struggle. And I have been living in Hong Kong around 20 years now. But I never see the class struggle here. This is my experience. Maybe somebody agree with me or not, but I never see the class struggle here. But system of the Hong Kong is very different what they explain to in the Marxism. But still, the Marxism is one of the biggest philosophy in the world, whereas it is not taught even in this hall. But I want to ask you again one more question. Who is not feeling the fear in the life? Anybody? Nobody has the fear here? I think the most of all, either the different kinds of fear we have. But again, the world population is now 6 billion people. All the 6 billion people, except more than 6 billion people, also has a fear. That is living things.
Actually, sorry for interrupt. Audience, you also can make a question for him. If you read his book, you can ask him. If you want to ask him, then you can put up your hands. But before that, I will ask him some more questions. Mr. Subba, I just want to know, you have mentioned new world here, like deep philosophy. What does it mean, actually?
Yeah, I have mentioned in my book, this is also the new terms, deep philosophy. I think most of the professors, I think here maybe so many professors and students as well who came from the literature or philosophy. Deep philosophy is, I think, the new term I'm just using. Deconstruction is already used by the postmodernisms, but deep philosophy is the new term I used. Because in deep philosophy, I just explain the meaning versus meaning. Because in the postmodernism is very famous one word is speech versus writing. Mostly all the postmodernism is considered in the speech versus writing. What I'm doing here is meaning versus meaning. What is the meaning of this meaning versus meaning? I want to explain about the world, about existing all the philosophies of the past. Just like I just give you the examples. One of the famous writers in the postmodernism is Gayatri Spivak. She's Indian. She's living in the USA and doing the, I think, California somewhere. She's doing the professor. One of her very famous book and the logic is, Can Subaltern Speak? This is the very famous book, the Can Subaltern Speak? The subaltern word is very famous from 1982. It is starting from the Indian, and my marginal people's voices here, marginal and mainstreams, and when they are just logically about the marginal's voice, they start the subaltern, and it is also came from the Antonio Gramsci, the Marxist, he's also from Marxist. But I want to just explain here the meaning versus meaning. Means what we are hearing about can subaltern speak? There is two groups in the world. One said subaltern can speak, and one says subaltern cannot speak. Like a Michael Fogelt, it's groups. I said just like groups. It is very easy to understand. He said subaltern, they have to speak themselves because that's their problem. Like a woman's. Woman has to speak themselves. In one angle, the woman is a feminist. They explain the woman's also in the subaltern. Whenever they are talking about subaltern, then woman's problem, they have to speak themselves. This is one point. And another point, Gayatri Spivak say, no, they cannot speak. Women cannot speak, or subaltern cannot speak themselves. Why? Because they are already subalterns. They are already dominated from the long time, from the culture, religion. There are so many parts, and they are dominated. And I just put some points in my Twitter and the Facebook. And I said, somebody is rap, like a girl is rap. And how many percent of the world, the rap girl speak themselves, their problem? Even the USA, even the UK, even the Hong Kong, how many people they can? Because number, very little number, they can speak. But because of culture, because of religion, because of system, they have the problem, they cannot. So I'm not doing any logic from these two parts. Their side. But my side from the meaning versus meaning is they cannot speak, I think also. I think also they can speak. Why? Because I think from my philosophy of theorism angle, if some people, either subaltern or non-subaltern, if that person is dominated from the long, long time, dominated from long, long time. It's not the power, but it's not from the political angle. Once they have been dominated or tortured from the long time, and their mentally development is automatically, they become the inferiority complex, like introversion. And they said, oh, I have already dominated people, then I cannot. That is not either the subaltern side, the Gayatri side, or the Michael Fogelt side. This is they develop from the mindset that I'm already dominated man. Dominated in community, so I cannot speak. They are doing like this because this is a fear, I said. So the fear is the new, just explaining. I just want to give you one more example. One very famous word of the Maoist. He said, power is in the barrel of gun. Everybody, I think, hear this word. It's a very famous word in all over the world. Whenever we are just looking at this sentence, power is in the barrel of gun. If that barrel has no power to killing the people, then can it dominate or can the power? Means whenever we are just talking about the weapons, atomic bombs, and it is already, the people are just be undercoming the control. If there is no power, like what is the difference between the barrel of gun and the flower? If you had to know the killing power, the flower and the gun is the same thing in the meaning. But flower cannot control anybody. Similarly, God has no power, no fear to the people, then God also cannot.
Can be a fear person. Can be a fear person.
Sorry?
What do you think about that? Is it anybody can be a person of fear?
Oh, you mean the can we reduce the fear?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh. Yeah, this is one of the very good questions, and everybody thinks that fear we never can be reduced or we get right from the fear. But this is the main thing, the fearism. And depends on, there are so many fears in our life. And one, the word is in the, I said the postmodernism, Jack Derrida has always using the one word, central, the meaning, central meaning. They are using the central meaning. In our terms here, we can say central fear. The central fear is, means, death fear is the major fear in our life. But death fear is also the difference. It is not always coming death fear in our life, sometimes. But I was just want to give some examples of the how can we reduce the fear, can we get right from the fear or not. Suppose somebody has a bank loan from the bank, $100,000, and it makes fear to the person who cannot pay the money back and is always afraid about that. And we see in the newspapers and some other medias, somebody doing the suicide because of the cannot pay the loan, his money back. This is the fear. So how he has to treat this fear? Now how can he minimize or how he have to be handle this his fear? And when we just go to the Buddhism, and Buddhism, I just borrowed some words from the Buddhism as well. And the Buddhism, he said the sorrow, how can we just be free and get out, get right from the sorrow? He has just given the three examples. Mostly the three is very common. Suppose when we are walking on the forest somewhere, and suppose tiger is coming. Tiger is the, he said, according to him, is that the sorrow, making the sorrow to him. Tiger is the problem. In other words, we can see the tiger is the problem. Or tiger is also the fear. And he said, either we have to face with the tiger, encounter with the tiger, the one, the point, or we have to escape from the tiger, another example, or if we have a power, then tiger just make to the cat. This is mindset, because fear is also the mindset. Sorrow is also the mostly the coming from mindset. It makes big, if we're thinking continuously, anxiety is increasing, then it is going to be very big, and it kills sometimes. It makes some kind of so many fear patient, like a depression, if we go just a depression and schizophrenia, some kind of diseases. All these, the symbols are the, what is called, symptoms. Just go to the fear side. But the whole, after now, medical science is not diagnosis. It is the fear disease. A fear medical, or fear the doctor, it is still not yet. Because fear is not looking at the broad sense. So
how can we use this in our practical life?
It is very easy so far. I'm using myself in some way. I just doing practically in myself. Just like I want to just give the examples to the students here and some of the employees as well. But very good example for the students, I think. The students are sitting at the exam, suppose, and during that time, what happened? The fear size is changed. Because fear size is also, just using the first term here, somebody believe or not, but fear has a size. But I'm not going to the very detailed size. I said maximum, minimum, and the lower, minimum and the medium size. Suppose the student is sitting in the exam hall, and he start to fear, oh, I cannot do exam. I cannot do so many difficult questions coming. Start to fear from the beginning, or start from anxiety or anything we can say, worry about that. But influence, the fear is more practical here. Fear, and when she or he is nervous, then even she knows the answers, but she cannot, because she already lost the control. Patient, she or he already lost. And we just go to the minimum side. Somebody is sitting in the exam again, and she has no fear about the exam. He's just doing the careless, and she again cannot do the exam. So for the students, they have to just keep the medium size, I said, because we need the fear. Or sometimes fear also doing the so many positive works, And we need to keep in the same. I want to give one example to the most of them. I think the audience here is, I think, driving the car, maybe. Whenever we are driving the car, and some car is passing through just beside of us, or some the animal, somebody crossing the road, or something happens on the when you're driving time. That time, if we have a more fear, maximum fear, what happened? Because we lose the control, and there is chances to be accident. And if we're doing it again, careless, and just singing and listening and talking on the mobile, and there is also the, again, there is a chance of accident. So we have to just keep the medium-sized fear when you're driving, when we are working, even we are working, doing the business. And the business is also going to have some problem coming, crisis, and they just panic, oh, very big crisis coming. Then you lose the control, you lose the patience, and he has also get unsuccessful.
Mr. Subba, you belong to HK ethnic minorities group. If you look at the philosophy of theorism from the ethnic minority angle, how we look?
This one is identical, the problem, all over the world. And this kind of question is mostly used to ask me from the Northeast India, because when they are doing some program and they just connect to me and I just call to them and the phone, they asked these questions as well. But the situation of the Northeast India and some other part of the world and the Hong Kong is quite different. We cannot compare the what they have. But I just want to give the example of the Northeast India is because there is the people are living like Nepalese people or some other migrant people are living from the 300-400 years. But still, the local people is not considered them, accept them as they are the citizens, they are the same people like that. And they always have the fear of identical problem. But in comparison with Hong Kong, the ethnic minority are also looking for the identity. And the Hong Kong people who are living here, also they have also the identity, they just want to save it. But both sides, they have a little fear. Okay, but the Hong Kong government so far is looking more to the ethnic minority as possible, try to integrate all of them. And the ethnic minority, the Hong Kong, has not a very big problem like the Northeast India and some of like South America, but more because government is already initiated and try to do their integration work. Then ethnic minority or some other minority communities, they don't feel like we are the minority here. And they feel like we are the integration, we are the part of the Hong Kong. So
you said life is conducted, directed, and controlled by the fear. Can you elaborate on some more?
Oh, yes. Suppose somebody is just finished the education, like a master's degree, some other degrees, and he's sitting at home, doing nothing, any jobs, any business, and later he think, he's conduct himself because he needs the money. He needs some society, the reputation, some kind of the his status he want to build up. So he is start, if I'm not doing my work, then I have to lose the prestige in my community, my society, and I need to eat and the food, some kind of the income I need. This is started because the fear is he's starting the doing some work. Even in the some business or some the employees, some working in the some places, like sitting. Somebody sitting at like a lazy and doing nothing, and he slowly fear. If my boss see me, then he will be fire me. And when once the fire is coming in the mind, the employee is losing the job. This fear is very strong fear, and this conduct to him. I need to do work.
You mention about the fear age group in your book. Especially, I read both of these. Very hard to understand somehow. Yeah. Beside this one, you mentioned about the fear age. Can you simplify this one?
Oh yeah, I have mentioned some fear age because the civilization is what we are considered today, the civilization and civilization again. This is mostly the base on the Marxism. Marxism has the four of the classes, he has already divided. But I think the fearism, I said in the eye of the fear, is starting from the all the civilization is not the what the Marxism said. Marx said, because he has just only make the four the groups, like there is the four. And I said the fear is because starting from the fear. First time we just developed some weapons, and later we just went to the agriculture stage, then the industrial stage, and I just make a divide it now is virus AIDS as well. I have the one mentioned there because virus is increasing all over the world every time. Sometimes Ebola coming, sometimes SARS coming, sometimes so virus tomorrow is also coming the more. So I just mentioned about the virus as well, and I also mentioned the cyber AIDS. I think cyber AIDS is also mentioned here because cyber is very fast going now, and cyber is the main reason now is making us the fear. Like USA has the one the atomic bomb, and he just pressed the button. This is all working by the cyber. And what we are doing is, last fear is the fearless. How can we be fearless? This is like one kind of utopia, because we have some keep the utopia and the philosophy, because if there's no utopia, one kind of expectation of our thinking, then how to go, direction must be need. So I went about reading and writing about this book, and I saw that most of the philosophies, they have some utopias. Because like postmodernism, again, I go to the Derrida. Derrida has written so many in the beginning. When he was young, at that time, he's just making so many discussions. The last when he was going to pass, that time he had just made the image of the city with the borderless. No border, all the cities, all the refugees, all the migrant people has no limit, no borders. They have to survive. They can be free everywhere. This utopia and the Marxism said, and the socialism last, there is no borders, no police, no country, everything is the same. This is also the utopia. But I said, we are trying all the time to be a fearless. Whenever we are success to be a fearless, then that life will be the happy and very peaceful perspective.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming again. If you want to know more about these books, you also can buy from Malaysian. And of course, you have a lot of maybe questions. If you want to ask, please put up your hands. Then we will pass the mic and you can ask. And Mr. Subba will try to answer your question.
Please, anybody has any question?
Or students? Oh, yeah.
You mentioned minimizing fear from maximum to medium. Can you talk about cope? Like, how do you do that?
Oh, yes. That's a good question, I think. And practical as well. The fear is first. Source of fear is the mindset. Because there is external and the internal fear. Sometimes external factor also makes us fear. The mostly, the fear is coming the internal source. When we're thinking and thinking more. So like I read the one book in the story of the Leo Tolstoy, and there is one very long story, I think it's 100 pages, but he said this is a story. But there is one character, and he has some kind of wound here. He just thinks, I have something here. And he's thinking, and later he's died because of only thinking, like some kind of mark I have here. So I want to just tell you the proving this the character is. Sometimes what happened to us, something I lost, or somebody is just chasing me. We think like this, okay? But nobody chasing exactly. Maybe thinking only, the mindset is thinking, I'm suffering from some kind of economic crisis or some family problem. We are just developing in our mind. When the degree of this thinking is going more maximum, then it makes so many kind of side effects, like depression, like I said, some mental problem. And this is only the production of the mindset only. Then how do we minimize this one is, we have to just reduce, cut it ourselves. This is nothing. I'm not being followed by anybody. So when you are doing like say yourself from the mind, then you can be reduced yourself.
Any other? Okay.
Well, I want to connect the little bit about the global political issue. So you think that now, right now, the problem with the US and the Middle East, So is this the relation more with the fear or the threat between these two parties? So this is creating more and more problem. So to make a more better relation, so I think, so how they can use this term of fearism to build a better relation between these two regions.
Thank you, Mr. Rai. I think it's better to mention your name because we are recording this one and maybe we need to write in the book because we are going to make a book of this program today, Hong Kong University Speech Philosophy of Fearism. Thank you. This is not the dispute between the two countries only. And this kind of the dispute comes in the individual friends as well. Today, A and B are the good friends. Tomorrow, they became their enemies. Mostly, this is happening in our daily life. What is the factor making the break to these two friends? And I think some coming the egos, some coming the jealous, some kinds of suspicious, and some kinds of identity maybe. The proudness, there's so many factors there. And all of these are, if we little bit minimize, like Peter and me, like we have some problem coming, and Peter is today, he said to me like this, why I have to listen to him? This is coming always like that in the human life. And to just finish our dispute, I said, oh, no, he's a good man. I need to be listened to him. And from my side, if my label is 51 before, we have a 50-50 all, and 1%, 51 is going there like ego only, or jealous only, or suspicion only. Then automatically problem is created. The Middle East and the USA, they have this kind of the problem as well. Sometimes they have the ego, sometimes they have suspicious, like they killed the Saddam Hussein because of suspicion, I think. They have the Saddam Hussein has some kind of missiles, weapon keeping them, and they suspect and they attacked, later they found nothing. This is the record, I don't know if I'm not wrong. So suspicion is starting, and behind the suspecting is their identity problem is coming. If China is rising the superpower tomorrow, then what about our position? USA is thinking like this. If Middle East is controlled by China and Russia, and what happened to our position? How can we take the oil resources and other resources? So they want to protect themselves for the future. And this is the protection is also the indirectly the fear, I think, fear. But there is some other problem as well. But to finish the dispute, both sides, they have to minimize their ego or the fear. If the fear is they lose, Syria or some other Gulf country is doing nothing. They are doing good. If USA start to think like that positively, and this problem will be solved.
Any other questions you want to make? You can ask. Okay.
Don't feel the impending complex before I say. Don't afraid to ask the questions, please. Okay. Yes, please.
I just wanted to ask, what made you write about this book? Why did you think of writing about fearism?
Oh yes. Sometimes the inventions is not we can achieve when we try. But sometimes it is automatically is coming to our life. Because so many professors here, maybe sitting here as well, they also try to do something in their life, new achievement they want to do, but still cannot. But somebody is, without doing the effort, they can also get the success. Some kind of new inventions, some kind of new the creations, they can do that. But for me, and yesterday also Sai Chana Morning Person quote that point is, when I was writing the manuscript, it's still not published, unpublished, that manuscript is, there was one word, fear. But I not pay attention there first time. It is written by me, but I have no focus, I no attention there. I have given to read that my manuscript to my friends for their comments, for their reactions. But when one of my friend, Saran Subba, is living in Yunglong, he just make underline in that my word. When he underline, and I just make attention there, oh, this word can be something. And that fearism word, I just try to find in the dictionary, and the encyclopedia, Google somewhere, I cannot find that one. maybe this can be something. Still, I am not confirmed. And I research and study more, try to find. I just consult with some professors who had already engaged in so many the books. But still, they cannot suggest me. And I spent around more than 10 years to just looking. If somebody already has developed this word, and I just working on these topics is no use, and my all effort will be the useless, then I later, after the, I have just done so many programs, so many interaction programs, but still, all of this said, this is a new world. Then I start to work. And whenever I start to work and look the world from this angle, and I said, like life is also suffering from the fear, the business and the politics, and I come to the conclusion that even the bank, even the fire stations, even the government, even the law, even everything is just to create the fear and control the society. I just came to the conclusion. Thank you.
So after all, maybe if you have questions, I will give you a mic. If not, okay.
In your perspective, what does it mean, fear? What does it mean by fear?
Fear is one human temperament. There are so many human temperaments, like a jealous, like a, the suspicious, like introversions, like infinity complex. There are so many. Among them, this is a one. But it is more influential to the others. Like there, I said before, there are so many. We have a human temperaments, characters. Somebody is more suspicious. And when we just go to the suspicious side and just look the background of the suspicious, why I suspect some person? And I found there is also the more percentage of suspicion is from the fear. Just like a, sometimes we have a dispute with the families, like a husband and wife. First time when just a husband and wife start to suspect, oh, my wife is going with somebody or my husband is going with somebody. Starting, the first point is suspicion. This suspicion is highly explained by the father of the modernism, like René Descartes. He's starting from the suspect, is the philosophy is, but he's just going to suspect, and he just want to go to the truth. And sometimes the, when we go to the truth, reality, suspicion, going to the reality. And sometimes reality is maybe not the fear. But sometimes it is more fear. But according to your question is, this is the human temperament, and all like other temperament is coming, and the fear is the master or the measure, the human temperament. It's affected to the everyone, every other temperament.
Yeah. Mr. Subba, you have mentioned fear brings us peace and happiness. You have mentioned about this word inside this book. So can you elaborate that?
Yes. Like a, we suppose like a, we are suffering from the money, and we are just try to get the money and work doing the business, and doing business. Whenever we get some kind of the achievement, and it's like a one angle only, just make some kind of the peace. But the main peace is there where we reduce our fear. Without reduce the fear. We cannot get the achievement. I just give you some examples. Maslow's theory, I think most of the university already teach the Maslow's theory, hierarchy of needs. We have a hierarchy of needs. We have a needs is increasing every day. Today we have no thing to eat. We try to find the eating. Then tomorrow, if we have a eating, then we try to make some good luxuries. Standards bringing up to the 5 level. But I just make a deep philosophy in the Abraham Maslow's this theory, because I look sometimes the some richest man, I don't mention the name in Hong Kong, the richest men, I sometimes work over there, and I know their life is. They cannot sleep whole night, and they are in the 3 o'clock, wake up and going outside. And I just read myself, and why they cannot sleep. And when they are, sometimes I just meet their drivers, and drivers keep so many medicines. Whenever they have a problem, they always have a medicines. They have so many money, still their life is not very, very happy and the peace. Because they have the more fear. When earning the more money, they have a more fear. And even some of the people, just we had a comparison with the, I used to compare some lives. Back in our country, people are very poor, that's right. But They have no income, that's also right. But one is very interesting thing I found. They just go to the labor work one day and bring something like some dollars, some money, and for just tonight, that night, they have enough for the food only. But still they can very nicely sleep. Tomorrow, what happened, they don't think. Tomorrow, again, go to the somewhere, some work, and again, earn. And every day, just they are earning, and every day, they finish. But still, their life is, I think, very better than our life in one comparison. But in Hong Kong, like same like I came from the Nepal, and I am here. From the 20 years, still I'm working and working. But
yeah, Subba has been working on his philosophy of Fearism since 1999. So he has published many books, more than four novels. It has mentioned about the marginalization in Nepal, some text, and the philosophy of Fearism. Many researchers involved in northern part of India, especially Sikkim, Assam, and other places. You can read these books, and today, thank you, Hong Kong Yu. Thank you so much. Maybe we are in almost end of this reading club, especially presentation. So thanks so much. Maybe Mr. Subba, you want to say something?
I think still we have a time, and I think my. If
you have questions, yeah,
of course, definitely. Please.
I want to ask, like, human, money, and weapons, what do you think human fear the most? Like, in three things, like human, money, and weapons.
Okay, human, money, and weapons.
Very difficult question. I do three things. Human, weapons, and money. It depends on the lifestyle. Somebody given focus on the humans, somebody given focus on the weapons, somebody given the focus on the money. And how he want to survive, how he want to expand his life, it depends on that. For somebody, money is no use. But somebody is no use for the weapons as well. And weapons is, I said, who holds? I read on one, I think somebody just put in the tute. And he said, in the USA, somebody keeping the guns for the hobby. Huh? For the hobby, somebody keep the guns? Maybe. But the hobby also, that is less, maybe protection is the more. Because mostly protect. Because all the thing is like this. Firstly, like we are wearing the cloth. First, we try to protect our body. Secondly, it is coming the fashions only. If today we don't have even to cover the body, then why how we go to the patients? In the ancient time also, they only do wearing the cloth, the bark, the tree, because they don't have anything, no alternations. So later they develop so many things and coming the patients. Even though today, like 1989, the Russia when the crisis in the Russia, the economic problem, they have no choice to eat. We see in the newspaper, in the TV, they only struggle doing for the bread, because there is going very collapse, their economic down. Even today in our life, suppose we are doing the business. If our business is going collapse, then again we have no choice. What we available, then we have to eat. And some of the places like that. So it depends on the human and the money and the weapons. The some of the people is not paying attention to the humans, like humanity, sociology, society. Somebody has no interest. And somebody is more interested in the society, development of the society, welfare of the society. Contribute, donate so many monies. But somebody just take from the money, from the, if somebody giving the donation, and the donation also be corruption is there. It depends on that. Okay?
Any other?
I wonder if you could talk a bit about leadership. Now leaders, great leaders, be they leaders of industry, politics, war, often described as fearless.
Sorry?
And they're described as fearless, as having no fear. Yet my understanding of fear, having fear, is that it drives you to be successful. So is that a paradox?
No.
Leaders who have no fear yet are greatly successful. How How does that work in your philosophy?
No, that's not, I think, the right. Because he want to success, he want to be leader in the political or the, some industry, some of the institutions. I have mentioned about the, in my book, there's a level of the fear in the organizations or the some of the family as well. To keep the family in order, we must have some kind of fear. And according to our system is, father is powerful in the family. Who has more income, that is powerful. In the same like the industry is also the power is control the discipline of the workers. If there's no fear, even the country, if there's no fear in the country, there is no police, no rule and regulation, nobody follow the rule and regulation, then that country will be the very disturbed and very difficult and coming down in the underdeveloped. The industry also, success of industry or anybody, person's life, they have to use the fear as a good weapons. And like a head of the department or head of the industry, he has to use his power or the fear to the according to the, their necessity. In some of the industries or some of the countries, very dictator type. There is organization, in the management and organization, there is this kind of topics as well. Some of the leaders are very dictative. Some of the leaders are very flexible with the friendship with the workers. It depends on. Sometimes the workers, if very good workers, then that is only we have to just normally or the formalities like family, we can work. But sometimes the workers are not like listening anything, orders, rules and regulations. They must need to put more power, more fear create. Just like in the world nowadays, rapping case is increasing. Everywhere, mostly in our countries now, rape case is very increasing because there is no fear to them. Even India, the very, very big problem was coming in the rape case because there is no fear of the, and there, not only the fear, there must be the solution, alternative as well. But Hong Kong is number of the rape cases low than the other countries. Why? Because one is strong the rule and regulation. Second is they have the alternation, some other solutions as well. So government cannot import only the power and make the fear like a dictator. It has a side effect as well. In the industry as well, the leaders must need to be think all the, this human behavior, humanities, and just use the power and fear to them to get success.
Any other?
Hello. I just wanted to ask you about why different people have different fears on them. How do they create their own fear?
Oh, connection with this one, I want to explain the origin of meaning because this is depends on the origin of meaning and consciousness and conditional reflex. I use many times in my book the conditional reflex. And the conditional reflex and the meanings, how the meaning is constructed, it depends on that. And personal structure as well. You are sitting in the first bench, the four of the girls, and the four boys, all things is not the same. Even the body structure, even the family background, even the education or perceptions or understanding, all is different. There is one psychologist, gestalt psychology I read in the side. He said, even the small part of anything is when moving, and it is effect to the whole the system. Just like in the example I make very clear, this is a book, it's very simple sentence. But in this is a book, we just make is this is an book. Only we put one N in the instead of A. All the structure, all the sentence, all the grammar is wrong now. Because only of one putting the A. Similarly, in the consciousness is little bit different. And difference the understanding power, learning power, explaining power, everything. And the consciousness of the structure is depends on the heredity as well. That's why I said in the book there, the points, how the meaning is constructed. And I make explain meaning, what is the meaning, and what is the meaning works. And I found, try to find the how the other philosophers and writers explain about this meaning. I found meaning can be transferred, moving like one place to another place. meaning can be upside down, up and down we can. Because I said marginal, central, first Derrida, just use that one. And you just make upside down and look. Long and parallel, there is the Ferdinand de Saussure, the linguistic from the Denmark. He was working in the modernism time. And he's just giving the impact in the long. Long means the group. Some of the thing is like four girls sitting here. Some of the thing are common. He has given the emphasis, the Ferdinand de Saussure is giving emphasis on the some common things, what is that? And common is given the importance, like a language, Shakespeare time and the now time, the 400 years difference, there's a lot of changes coming in the English language. But according to their the understanding, their explanation, de Saussure and the modernism, the explanation is even the language is changed, but some grammar is not changed. They said like that. So this some the factor, the major factor is not changed, they said. And Derrida and some of the postmodernism say, no, that means it must be done to change. So I just study in the meaning then. What is the meaning and how the meaning is constructed? I came to the conclusion that meaning is only the caricature. Education is only the caricature. Learning is only the caricature. How? This is the question. How the caricature? Just like I just give you the example. Suppose when a small baby, the 2 years baby, how he start to learn education, writing, everything. We teach, parents start to teach that 2 years child. First we try to teach the speak and we teach him A, letter A, suppose. That child, that small baby, pronounce, follow to us. First he follow our caricature, the mouth sound, how the mouth is moving. And sound is catch. And you just want to learn that is, that's only the caricature of parents teaching to that boy. Secondly, we just go to writing then. We teach that baby, write A, just move your hand like this. That baby is just copy out, just doing the caricature, copy only. Just follow our steps. Then he is learning and writing A. Then go to the word. How the word? Like a rice. Then baby follow the rice and writing rice. That is also the just like a caricature parents. And when you go to the university, is like this. So many, I think the university, the high school students here. What is our education then? Education is the caricature of the books only. The professors, mostly the professors cannot go beyond the text. Like we are the freelance, so we can use the words. But professor, what the mechanism they come to the study and teach to the students, that mechanism, that trend, they cannot change. Because whenever they change, that is one kind of revolution. Either you can be success or you can be fail. They cannot dare to change the systems. Like I said, the Abraham Maslow, or I just wanted to give the Darwin's theory. Darwin's evolution theory, I have so many the questions. Because natural selection cannot be natural selection. This is one very top, the topics of the Darwin. I am not agree with him. No, there is no natural selection. Then what? What is the selection then? The self persons or the animals, they have to select themselves. So I can say like that. But I think the professor who came from the evolution, just learning and teaching to them, they cannot say, oh, no, there is no natural selection. When the students writing that one, they will be fail the exam. I want to just give the example of the why, no, there is no natural selections. And person has to select themselves. Person or animals. And he just give the example of the dinosaurs. Why vanish from this world? Dinosaurs vanish from this world, not because of natural power. Dinosaurs vanish from this world because dinosaurs cannot adapt the situations. I just give you a more clear example. Some of the countries average living age is 60 years. Some of the countries, like if you just see the Hong Kong, now 86 years. USA, Japan, and some other countries have this 86 years. Some of the countries even have the 50 years. Why like this? Why difference? According to nature, all the human being is the same. Okay? Even the some disaster, natural disaster is coming. Somebody can save their life. Somebody can die in the same. Suppose like we are sitting in this hall today. Coming here, earthquake, bombarding here, suppose. Or bombarding is a human being. Like a natural, like an earthquake coming here. This is the nature, this nature is equal for all the people here who are living, sitting here in the hall. But somebody can hide very quickly inside somewhere. He can save. Or somebody can run very fast. He can also save, maybe. Or somebody cannot do anything, just like a sacrifice. Oh, I want to die. Then they can be die. So that is the somebody survive, somebody die. This is not selection by that earthquake. That is selected by the human themselves because of their capacity, their language. So the meanings are how they constructed. All the meanings is what we are learning today is only this caricature of the meaning. Because they have just still like a Jack Lacan or like a Derrida, the meaning is like a moving. Yes, I agree the meaning is moving, but how the meaning is originated, that is the point. I said in my philosophy of Fearism, meaning is originated from two ways. One is natural things, and another one is human-made things. Natural thing, we not create that one, but we give the names, we give the meaning, like a stone. Stone is not created by the human being. It is not the invention of the human. But it is originally coming from the nature. Then our forefathers, our ancient people, they just give the name in their local language. Like a Hong Kong Chinese, they give the one name for the stone. The English people give the one name for the stone according to their use. But later on, what happened that? We are just copy. Okay? Just today, I just explaining the philosophy of Fearism. And tomorrow, what is going on? Some of the listening here. Oh, Desh Subba said like this. This like this is going to copy to the others. He said in his book is like that. Same like that, I said, Maslow said the hierarchy of needs. We just copy this one. Oh, Maslow said hierarchy of needs. We follow and we write that is. So the human made is we give the name. Like a Marxism, when the Marxism word coming, automatically our mind is start to work. And this is the class struggle and labor's the point, like this automatically coming. Nobody need to tell because we already copy the meaning. And some of the natural things, stone, I said, stone. We just look the character or we look the all the shape of the stone, then we give the name. This name is fit for this object, these goods. Then later on, second man, second person, third person is just copy. Oh, this stone is like that, let us. And why I study this about the meaning, the original meaning, because I have also explained the meaning of the fear. The ghost, like example, a ghost. What is the ghost? Only the meaning. So when we are a child, and our parents, our teachers used to say, oh, ghost is the danger, and it is coming nighttime, and it makes fright into us. So you need to be very careful with the ghost. And our mind is already pick up that ghost. And whenever somebody says ghost, means automatically we start to fear. This is only the meaning. But like sometimes good ghost, there is also good ghost. Helping the ghost also in the stories means. But we never think like the helping the ghost. Like somebody, we are sitting here, some snake is coming. Snake, we already panic hearing the snake. But there are so many snakes. So many good tigers, somebody keep the tigers at home nowadays. But we never think that tiger can be kept at home, snake can be kept at home like a pet. But because our meaning, what we observe the meaning is, this is danger thing, and start to fear. So all this meaning only, the fear. Because whenever we have ghost, then I want to just give one example of the Pavlov's theory. I think this is very famous in the world. That is called conditional reflex theory. I used many times, many places in my book, but somebody told me that it is already death, it has no use, but I think it is very useful to me. What is the conditional reflex is, the scientist has done the experiment in the dog. I think most of you already hear that is. He experiment in the dog. Dog is tied up like this, and so everything is ready, and they make ready for the just coming the rice here and just ready for eating, or something is ready. And when somebody just like a light on, and rice is automatically coming, and he is ready to eat. And every half an hour, they are doing this experiment for 1 month. Now what happened, the result is, after 1 month, sitting like this in the position, when the light is on, even the rice is not coming, already saliva is coming in the mouth. Water is coming in the mouth because his sense is starting to think, oh, rice, my rice is coming. And the later, they also do the experience. Another 1 month, they light on and they don't give the food to the dog. And later, the saliva, water is coming to stop. Then I just use this one is in the so many places. Just like sometimes we go to the new place, some friend's house, and he just give us to the bed, good bed, even the golden bed. But we cannot sleep that place because our body is not adapted that one. But our bed is even the very bad or very the broken somewhere the beds are, but still we can sleep. Like a sofa set we are sitting, we are very sleepy. This is automatically like a conditioned reflex of the dog. Our body is already adapted. When we are in the small time, somebody, uncle, auntie coming and give some chocolate. One day he's giving chocolate, and the second day also giving chocolate. Third day, we automatically, our mind is start to work. Oh, uncle coming, give us the chocolate. Even not giving, we are already thinking like this. And the fourth, 5 day or the another day, he's not start giving, oh, this uncle is not giving anything now. Because our mind is adopting like this. This is called conditional reflex. He just used in the dog, and I used in the human life and personally myself. Somebody is always giving lysi. In Hong Kong, it's a lysi system. I want somebody working in the like a babies or uncle, auntie give the lysi. Oh, this auntie is very good. She's giving the lysi. His mind is already start to walk. And meaning is also same. All the life is also the same. Thank you.
So you think the meaning can be changed, like it cannot be statics, the meaning.
Meaning
yeah.
is changed according to the person's perception.
Yeah, I think recently I feel like that, you know. Mm-hmm. When you talk about the word of a dictator, you know, mm-hmm. we put it in a very in a negative and protagonist. But now we just recently, the Lee Kuan Yew, the Prime Minister of Singapore, he passed away. And mostly people think he was a dictator. But even though he was a dictator, he was a good leader. So I think we put the dictator in a very in a antagonist, a negative way. I think it doesn't work. I think he was a dictator, though he was a good leader. So I think we cannot put the dictator as only in a negative side. Is that way? What do you mean?
your question is, Mr. Peter's question is almost similar because the leader's question is coming. So leaders. I also read today, I think, the Lee Kuan Yew's life, and he just make one team, and team make a success to Singapore, like this. So leaders and the publics, all is only depends on the understanding. Even though like Barack Obama is democratic and very popular in the world, but somebody, he doesn't like to him. It depends on somebody like very much the Saddam Hussein. Somebody like very much the Hitler. It depends on the understanding. But the leaders are the person, or the family, the head, or the institution head is try to be good for their institution. How to? Sometimes I said implement more rules and regulations, strict rules. Make strict rules also necessary sometimes, sometimes not. Like I think what was in the Singapore that time, 1960 around, but I think even his dictator, I think he said, he think that is the only the best way. So he implement and he make a success. Ultimate goal is the success. But I think the Singapore people, I think they are mostly not listening that he is a very dictator. But dictator is also sometimes good. Like out of control, some of the place, some of the family must be implement the very strong rules. That is the dictator, I think.
Okay, this is the end. Almost we are in the end of this book talk. Yes, sir. Please.
Okay, well, thank you. That was a very interesting book talk. I can honestly say we've not had anything like it previously. We'd like to thank both of you, Desh Subba.
Oh,
thanks
thank
very
you.
Much.
Thank you very
Souvenir,
much.
Souvenir, thank you. And Ray Devraj,
thank
you. Same
thank
for both
so
of you. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Just two announcements before you go. If you enjoyed the book talk, our next book talk will be on the 30th of April. By Paul Letters, and he is the author of the book called A Chance Kill, which was recently the number one seller in the SCMP fiction list and page one list as well. It's a historic thriller set in Second World War Poland. We're also, on the 20th of April, going to have an exhibition of John Thompson photographs. John Thompson was a great photographer in the late 1800s in China and in Hong Kong as well. And we have some prints that we'll be showing over a two-week period. So please come and see our events. If you're not on our mailing list, give Gary, your card, and you will get all of our notices. Thanks for coming, and thanks again to our speaker and our moderator. Thank you.
Thank you.